Hello students, welcome to my 10th video. As we remember, we had done this lesson, The Adventure of the Mason. The explanation was over. Now we are going to see the question answers. That is, we will discuss the question answers given at the back of the lesson. So we see here there are two different categories of questions, one A and B. Under A we see extract based questions. And under B, there are long answer type questions. Now, before I start discussing, I would like you to know that whatever I am discussing here is just my point of view. You are always welcome to write the answers, write the points that come in your mind in these answers, but they should be relevant and correct. So, let us see what we can write. The first one, A, is an extract based question. One extract is given here. Now, said the stranger, you must help me to bring forth the bodies that are to be buried in this vault. Who said this and to whom? That is the first question. We know that this was said by the stranger to the mason. Next question we see here, how did the person feel on hearing these words? We know that the mason here is the person. The mason felt very much scared and frightened when he heard the stranger talking about some bodies. He was frightened and he started imagining the terrible sight of the bodies that he was going to see. And he started imagining that these some bodies are lying nearby which he was going to see. He was very much scared and started trembling there. So this is what we can write here. Next, let us see. Did the person really see dead bodies? Now we know that he didn't see dead bodies there. Instead, there were big jars, 3 to 4 jars kept there full of wealth. So that is what you will mention here. Now these long answer type questions are such where you will be adding your own points, because these are the kind where you need to give a deep thought to the lesson. I'll mention some part of the answer and rest you will be writing it yourself. So let us see. The first question is, the story begins by stating that the mason was poor. Why do you think he was poor? Give reasons for your answer. So your reasons is given. I am going to give just one reason. The other reason you will be writing it yourself. So what I feel that the mason was poor because of his honesty. Since he was very honest, he never did anything wrong to make any illegal money. He was his profession, masonry, always had a way to do anything illegal and cheat the people, cheat the customers. He could easily do that, but he never did, and he remained honest to his profession, to his work. That is why he could never improve his living condition. So that is one reason, and that is of course a good thing that he was honest to himself, to his work. So that is what I feel. His honesty never allowed him to do anything wrong and make good money in short span. And that is why he remained poor. So that is one thing I feel. The other one, the other reason you will write yourself, giving a deep thought to the lesson, to the story. Next, let us see. Why do you think the mason agreed to the work even though he had to be blindfolded on the way? Now, we know that the mason was very much poor and required work and money for his family, to take care of his large family. So, even the condition was laid by the stranger, and even though the situation was very unusual in which he was offered the work, he agreed. And we know what was the situation. means in the middle of the night some stranger comes to his house and ask him to do some work for him, and also he would be taken to the place where the work to be done blindfolded. He would be taken there. So this situation and these conditions look very unusual, even though he agreed and went with the stranger. So this thing shows us that how much poor he was and how much in need of work he was. So that's what you'll mention here. Next, last question: how did the mason take advantage of his lucky chance? I'll give you a shot of it. You will write down the exaggerated form of this answer, the long one. I'll just give you a few hint about it. How he took the advantage. Here you will mention that the character trait of the mason, that he was honest and very clever at the same time. Honesty, we know about it. Here you will mention how cleverly he took advantage of the situation. The offer given by the man who came to give him the second time to give him the work, how cleverly he took advantage of it and said to him that he would be doing the repair work of the house only if he is allowed to live there rent free. So the landlord, who was the man, he was already miser. He wanted the repair work to be done without any cost, so readily agreed and gave him the permission to go and stay there and do the repair work. So in this way, the landlord was also not going to pay anything to the mason, because in return he was allowing him to stay in that house. So this is what we see here, how he used his intelligence and went to the house, stayed there, and gradually he used to take out money, and finally he became rich and one of the wealthiest men in Granada. So that is, you will write down in his exaggerated way how all these things happened in the end. So that is all about here. You will mention, you'll write down these answers neatly in your copy. And what else you required to do, let me summarize you. You will first write down a short summary of the lesson in the beginning of the chapter. First, short summary of the lesson. Then you will mention the word meaning, making them written very neatly. Columns you will make here, the word column, then the meaning column, and then the part of speech column, just as we did in class 6. After that, you will be moving to the question answers given at the back, and few questions I'll be sending you through assignment. You mention them along with these questions at the end of the lesson in your copy. So this is, I'm reminding you once again, first you will write down a short summary, then word meaning, and then the question answers given at the back, and including the questions that I am going to send you through the assignment. So that is it you're going to complete for now. Next, we will see another lesson. Take care. God bless you all.